First, allow me to give you five reasons why it is practicable to have a two-party system. Number one, better choice. Number two, clearer choice. Number three, platforms versus personalities. Number four, efficiency. And number five, simplicity. Number one, better choice. In a two-party system, people will be able to choose candidates better. So it's more practical. It'll be easier to cast votes with a shorter list of candidates. And the results will be out sooner as well. Number two, the choice is clear. It's more clear. A two-party system prevents confusion. The electorate clearly identifies the candidates and their respective party affiliations. Number three, platforms versus personalities. Platforms are highlighted instead of the personalities of the candidates. There will be clear choices in terms of governance for the electorate. Number four, efficiency. A two-party system means less work for teachers during elections. Cheating is also minimized, as only few candidates run for public office. And of course, my favorite, a two-party system means a simpler and shorter ballot.
Congresswoman Risa, your questions?
Thank you, Twing. Attorney Adel, you said that the two-party system would lead to better choices for our citizens and our voters. What if the only two candidates up, or the only two parties up, are not really their candidate or party of choice? What if the one they would be forced to vote under a two-party system is simply the lesser evil for them? Is that something that we should be happy about?
Definitely we shouldn't be happy about that, but under the two-party system that is that I am envisioning, and in fact already is happening in the United States, you go through a weeding out process. So that choice that as you prefer under a multi-party system is already there. Just like in the United States, before President Obama became the choice for the Democratic Party, he went through the primary process. And I think that's really what we need in this country. The reason why we have such a problem choosing our presidents, and the reason why we end up having minority presidents, is because we don't have primaries. If we had primaries, we would come up with the best choices, and we will have a better choice by choosing from two of the best instead of choosing from the lesser evils.
Attorney Adel, you keep mentioning the example of the U.S. political system, but again, of course, we come from a very different political context than them, having unsuccessfully waged a revolution for national sovereignty. They succeeded. They, in fact, were critical to aborting our victory over Spain. But in any case, you also mentioned that a two-party system would promote the politics of platform versus personality. But even in the pre-1987 Constitution Philippines, we had raging politics of personalities. Platforms were not yet the currency of the time. And even now that we are still struggling to build that open and free or multi-party system envisioned by the Constitution, this is more observed in the breach.
Well, I believe that personality politics will always form some element of politics. Politics is a human institution. But at the end of the day, a two-party system with parties that have clear-cut platforms will minimize us choosing our candidates just on the basis of their personal qualities. And that is a future that I'm hoping that we will have in this country. Thank you.
Attorney Ruth?
Attorney Adel, am I correct in saying that your vision of a two-party system will entail a block voting for
block
one
voting?
Party?
No. Unlike the United States that has its its own unique system where you have your electoral colleges,
yeah.
When you vote for president, it includes the vice president. That I do not envision it in that form. For me, it is still two parties, but you're able to pick and choose. It's really the simplification of the choice. Right now, we have a multi-party system, and we're having difficulty choosing because we did not go through the weeding out process.
Attorney Adel,
yes.
You mentioned the problem of having a plurality or minority presidents. Wouldn't that be solved by simply mandating runoff elections?
Well, definitely. In fact, one of the in Latin America, where they have multi-party systems, the reason why they are able to form more or less stable governments is because after the initial run, you have a runoff. So I think that is also one way to do it. But in order to do that, you will really have to amend the Constitution. But my argument is, and I have reviewed the Constitutional Commission records, you do not have to amend the Constitution to foster a two-party system. In fact, in the United States, the two-party system was a product of 200 years of evolution. It doesn't have to be constitutionally, there is no need for a constitutional amendment in order to obtain that. And so it's easier than creating that runoff scenario.
Okay.
Thank you.
Congresswoman Risa, for the negative side, 2.5 minutes to argue that reviving the two-party system is not practicable.
Thank you, Twin. Over and above the issue of needing to change the Constitution, the two-party system is particularly impracticable because of the institutionalization of the party list system, through which we've made some important gains in securing avenues for active citizenship from the marginalized sectors who have very little opportunities or had very little to participate in politics and governance, especially in the previous two-party system. While it's true that there are certain flaws in the party list law and problems, challenges in its implementation, these are not incurable and only make it imperative to reform the system rather than revert to the two-party system. As I said, these concepts have been institutionalized in our political consciousness and can no longer be ignored, such that it would be perhaps almost impossible to revert back to a two-party system. Or put another way, the party list system has given life to the right of each and every Filipino to be represented in government. And this must not be undermined by the establishment of a two-party system. I'd like to address one of the points earlier referred to by Attorney Adel. I also believe that in the matter of practicability, there's no genuine two-party system that can arise unless we remove the pork barrel and the executive horse whipping that is inflicted on the legislature using the pork barrel. The real reform, not an impracticable reversal to the two-party system, but the real solution and practicable solution is continuing electoral reforms, including campaign finance reform, developing internal party democracy, and leveling the playing field so that existing legitimate political parties, especially the smaller parties which arguably better represent mass-based grassroots interests, can evolve into stronger and independent voices that can actually make their presence felt in the political arena. Lastly, the proposition to revert to a two-party system is impracticable in the current or even the future Philippine context because of several additional reasons. The geographical and cultural diversity of the Philippine nation demand a more inclusive, participatory, I could even say diverse approach to democracy than a two-party system can afford. And this is best exemplified, and this is my last point, I hear the bell, best exemplified by the fact that a free and open or multi-party system is mandated by the Constitution, which we would probably need to change before we can revert back to the two-party system. Thank you.
Your questions, Attorney Adel.
Congresswoman Hontiveros, is it your position that a party-less system cannot exist side by side with a two-party system? Yes or no?
In principle, no.
All right. If that is the case, then could you please explain why the 1987 Constitution has stated that we will have a free and open party system, which, according to the constitutional debates, allows for the evolution of a two-party system, and yet we have a partyless system coexisting side by side with that free and open party system. Doesn't that seem to be inconsistent? If you say that it cannot, you cannot have a partyless system under a two-party system, when in fact the framers themselves said that this is possible. How would you explain that?
Well, in fact,
Congresswoman Hontiveros.
Yes, in fact, Attorney Adel, I'm becoming more formal, Attorney Tamano. In fact, what I responded to your earlier question was that it isn't impossible for a partyless system, to exist in a two-party system. But in the Philippines, given our experience and context, highly, highly improbable, almost impossible. So why did the 1987 Constitution speak to these two issues in that way, about the free and open party system and the partyless system?